Thank you. The final item of business is a member's business debate on motion 14125 in the name of Sue Webber on a new Winchburgh train station. This debate will be concluded without any questions being put, and I would ask those members who would wish to speak in the debate to please press the request to speak button, and I call on Sue Webber to open the debate. Around 7 minutes, please.
Thank you very much, Deputy Presiding Officer, and I'd want to thank everyone that stayed behind this evening and is contributing to the debate. And most people will know it's been something that's been close to my heart since I've been elected as an MSP. Last year, I did launch an online campaign calling for the Scottish Government and Transport Scotland to come together to fund and build a new station at train station at Winchburgh. And in April, campaigners and residents from Winchburgh came to the Scottish Parliament to deliver a petition with over 2,000 signatures to the SNP Government asking for the train station to be built at Winchburgh. And I was pleased to be able to meet them that day and show my support for this vital campaign, along with many others in the Chamber too. So I'm also therefore very glad to have the chance to raise it in Parliament today on our very first day back in this session. Over the summer, on one of the rare dry days that we did have, I did manage to get out and have another insightful tour around a rapidly growing village. And some SNP ministers may criticise me for being late to the campaign for the station, but in August 2020, prior to my election in 2021, my sister bought her home in Winchburgh. And I knew then how desperately the community needed and still needs this station. So I have vowed on my election day to do all that I could to deliver this station for the people of Winchburgh. Winchburgh is a vibrant and growing community in West Lothian, which currently finds itself isolated from the national rail network. The lack of direct access severely restricts the ability of residents to reach essential medical services, pursue educational opportunities, and connect with employment across the region. The establishment of a new railway station would dramatically enhance the connectivity and ease congestion in West Lothian and the west end of Edinburgh. And given the absolute chaos I think we're seeing right now on the A8, I think it would be really quite mindful if that was there, a little time travel involved. So all of these things are there and really does support our ambitions to provide sustainable transport solutions. The region, after all, anticipates 4,000 new families as a direct result of the investment leveraged from the Edinburgh and South East Scotland City Region deal. And demand for more robust public transport options has never been urgent and will continue to grow. Winchburgh Developments Limited is the principal landowner and has worked in partnership with Winchburgh Community Council and the Community Development Trust. The local authority and the Scottish Government specified that integrated travel must be key part of the overall development, and already we have lots of shops, pharmacy, soon to be two, we've got new schools, motorway junctions, and Winchburgh Developments paid £20 million towards making all of this possible. Winchburgh Developments has clearly shown considerable commitment to this expanding community, and the motorway junction has certainly helped, the already busy bus and the bus and the already busy bus service, and of course made it much easier for the average two-car household to literally get out of the fast lane into the capital. But improving the roads so that cars can move around and more easily doesn't really do much for integrating travel, and it doesn't do much for our net zero ambitions either. Because after all, the main railway line west from Edinburgh runs through the middle of the development site. There is a space set aside for a new station around the track, and there's plenty of car parking space already there. And it would keep virtually thousands of people off the roads in their cars every day of the year. Yeah. And they would be going onto the train tracks. That's what integrated travel means. And we do, after all, hear again and again the importance of getting people out of their cars into mass public transport solutions. And there's no point in getting on a bus to sit in the traffic jam on the A8, the Kirstorfen Road, St John's Road, all the way into town. That defeats the purpose. An 11-minute train journey versus a 47-48-minute commute on a good day. A study for transport consultant Sistra estimates that a station would remove 420,000 car journeys a year and help passengers save £2.4 million a year, with 3.5 million of decongestion benefits. Yet, despite a commitment of several million pounds ring-fenced from the outset from the developers and the offer of as much professional help required to physically plan and build the station, the Scottish Government continue to refuse to meet a penny of the shortfall that would guarantee that integrated travel for potentially tens of thousands of people. I don't understand the logic in that at all. And I appreciate finding £10 million, especially in the current climate, will not be easy, but that's a fraction of the Scottish Government-approved tram project in Edinburgh that was so badly mishandled. And let's not even start on the maths that we've heard about earlier on what that might be in terms of a properly organised ferry contract. And the developers have faced so many barriers, not least a sluggish Labour-controlled council in both West Lothian and Edinburgh, and the reluctance of Transport Scotland. But when I visited, the progress to see that has been extraordinary, and the quality of the homes is notably high. No wonder people want to move there. It is not a dreary estate, but an exciting new place to live, with affordable homes built to mirror the old miner cottages, so there's that real sense of place and continuity. Everywhere you look, there are new homes, and it's quite a transformation, and the pace of change continues at this accelerated speed. Until recently, there was nothing but excuse after excuse from Transport Scotland. And in fairness, the new SNP connectivity, Mr Jim Fairley, had responded positively to the WDL's determination and community pressure. And I want to thank him for that. Blockages might be dissolving. Money might be found. And I see no viable reason why the new main halt line can't be built by the end of 2026, giving new residents the vital links to their workplaces and extended services available from all the various neighbouring areas. And there is, of course, another very good reason for building a new station at Winchburgh. The physical station works, tracks, rolling stock and everything else will be built by members of the Railway Industry Association. RIA has been the trade body for the supply chain part of the industry for over 150 years and already brings 56,000 jobs at all levels to Scotland. Just think how many more will be created in a part of West Lothian that badly needs good quality jobs for men and women that the rail industry will bring. I have quite a bit, Presiding Officer. Is that okay for me to carry on? Okay. RIA supports...
For a short time, yes.
I'll not be going on all night, I promise. RIA Scotland supports the campaign for a new station at Winchburgh. And although, funnily enough, I wasn't there, I had heard that the Cabinet Secretary, in whose constituency this development lies, said at a recent fringe meeting at their conference that a station is a rather good idea. And with her support and that of every other party in Parliament, who else do we need to persuade to just make this happen? And finally, Presiding Officer, we don't have the luxury of time in West Lothian. If we don't start to make a new station in the next 24 months, we'll lose that space that's been ring-fenced for the station and the car park, as the demand to build more houses will mean they need the land for homes. So you'll find a few more property owners with zero transport integration beyond an increasing busy new road junction. I commend Winchburgh Developments for their commitment and substantial contributions towards making this vision a reality. Their involvement is a testament to the power of community and corporate collaboration in driving forward public projects. It is now time, however, for the Scottish Government to match that. A new station at Winchburgh is essential. It is not only a necessity to alleviate mounting congestion in our capital, but a critical factor in meeting the Scottish Government's failing net zero ambitions. Thank you, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Ms Webber. I now call Gordon MacDonald to be followed by Graeme Simpson. Mr MacDonald.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and I thank Sue Webber for raising this motion for debate. Before I speak about the proposal for a railway station at Winchburgh, I have to bring to the attention of the Chamber that my wife, Janet Campbell, has been a local councillor for Winchburgh since 2007. Both my wife and my friend and colleague, Fiona Hislop, have been at the forefront of the community campaign to bring a station to the area. There have been plans for a railway station going all the way back to the original Edinburgh to Glasgow improvement plan, but unfortunately, they had to be dropped because of the financial crash in 2008, which saw a reduction in the capital funding available at the time. However, we should always remember that this is and has always been a developer-led initiative and was used to support the case for building the new town at Winchburgh. The development of the village into a new town has been taking shape over many years since the planning permission was granted in April 2012. Since then, there have been new high schools, feeder primary schools, new retail centre, new public park at Old Cathay, and nearly 3,800 new homes, which brings the old village of Winchburgh up to the size of Linlithgow, but still no station. But given the growth of the surrounding area, it came as no surprise that in the autumn of 2019, there was an announcement of Transport Scotland and Network Rail that they were going to examine again the cord proposal at the Dalmeny to Winchburgh Junction line. This would be considered as part of the Edinburgh Waverley Western Approaches project. The constituency MSP Fiona Hislop hosted a visit back then with the then Transport Secretary Mike Matheson and numerous other transport interest groups, including ScotRail and Network Rail. The obstacle, as always, was and is funding. The development company, West Coast Capital, had budgeted £10 million for the Winchburgh railway station, but this was pre-Brexit and pre-COVID. The impact is that construction inflation has increased by nearly a quarter in recent years and is expected to increase by a further 15% over the coming 5 years. The result is the developer is seeking funding from the public sector, but at a time when the Scottish Government has had its capital budget cut in real terms by Westminster. There is no doubt there is a need for a station at Winchburgh, given that a new station could serve over 13,000 people who are within walking distance of the station, and double that number for those who could travel to the station to make use of the facility. Given the reduced journey times by train to 15 minutes, which is substantially quicker than the current 50 minutes by car or 60 minutes to Waverley by bus, there would, I believe, be a substantial number of people who would become regular rail commuters. So we have the passengers and the trains, we just need a station. So we need to find a solution. We need to find a way forward, and there is one possible solution. That is being considered by the Winchburgh Rail Steering Group, which is to progress the preparation of the business case for the railway station as an essential element of the application for City Region Deal strategic site funding. This fund is at least £50 million and is to be shared across seven key areas, including Winchburgh. This would still need a substantial contribution from the developer, but a partnership with the Scottish Government would help to remove tens of thousands of car journeys per year from our roads, resulting in improved air quality and reduced greenhouse gases. The steering group is supported by the local MSP Fiona Hislop and local councillors, and have agreed a set of actions and are moving the project forward together. I wish them all every success in their endeavours.
Thank you, Mr. MacDonald. I now call Graeme Simpson to be followed by Faisal Chowdhury. Mr. Simpson.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Can I congratulate Sue Webber for securing this debate? As long as I've known Sue, she has championed this issue. But this really isn't about, you know, who's been campaigning the hardest for this. I think this is about bad planning. Mm-hmm. And if you've planned a development of this size with a railway going through it, mm-hmm. then there should be a station. And that should have been planned and agreed at the start, because as Winchburgh has grown, you know, the need for this station has become ever greater. Now, I was outside the Parliament in April with Sue Webber and others. I see Faisal Chowdhury over there. He was there too, and there were others at the launch of the petition, or the handing in of the petition. And I've also been lucky enough to visit Winchburgh. I was shown round by Winchburgh Developments in May, and I also cycled along the canal, which goes through Winchburgh, over the summer. It's quite well connected by road and canal, but not rail. And yet there's a railway line going through it. And this is not difficult. This can be done. The Cabinet Secretary sat there, knows I live in East Kilbride. There's been money spent now on the East Kilbride line. The town is getting a new station at Haremyres. It's going to be fantastic, with a new big park and ride. That station, I suspect, will become the main station in East Kilbride. And that's been done with Scottish Government money. Gordon MacDonald mentioned City Deal money. I agree with him. That could be used. That decision should have been taken years and years ago. If we have an ambition, which we do, to get cars off the road, the Scottish Government certainly has that, and we would agree with that, then train travel is the way forward. And you can have a 15-minute journey from Winchburgh into Edinburgh, which would take hundreds of thousands of cars off the road every year. Surely we can all agree that this should happen. But there is hope. Jim Fairley has possibly provided some hope with the steering group, which met in July, at the end of July. And I hope that we can get beyond just a business case and getting an actual agreement to actually do something. Mm-hmm. Building a station is not, it really isn't all that complex, Presiding Officer. There just needs to be agreement to do it, and let's stop fighting about who's going to take the plaudits and who needs to spend the money. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Simpson. I now call Faisal Chowdhury to be followed by Lorna Slater. Mr. Chowdhury.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I would like to begin by congratulating Sue Weaver on bringing this important issue to the Chamber. I'm grateful to see members across parties who feel strongly about this issue. I hope we can continue to campaign and deliver for the people of Winchburgh. Since I first raised Winchburgh in the Chamber in 2022, some progress has been made. I have engaged with the council, developers and questioned three successive ministers for transport, highlight the needs for improved transport links for Winchburgh. However, my request to meet the ministers have been denied, and the Scottish Government until recently has failed to meaningfully engage. The reformation of the Winchburgh Railway Station Steering Group is welcome, but must be met with clear action. Above all, stakeholders, including MSPs, must work together to achieve this. Winchburgh itself is a fast-growing town and needs improved public transport options. Since 2012, 1,000 houses have been built, with 4,000 more planned. Its population is predicted to raise to over 13,000 by 2031, similar to Linlithgow, which has its own train station. It is estimated that catchment area of a train station in Winchburgh would benefit 26,000 people, and the proposal is popular. Earlier this year, I joined Winchburgh residents in delivering a petition to the Scottish Government, signed by more than 2,000 people, calling for a date to be set for the opening of the station. But it isn't just those in Winchburgh who would benefit. Over 400,000 cars off the road every year, millions in saving for passengers in transport costs, and millions saved in the congestion benefits. It makes economic and environment sense. Sue Weaver is right to mention the $50 million invested already by Winchburgh Development into infrastructure, including a new primary school. We should be encouraging and rewarding developers who proactively create well-connected communities. A key issue that must be addressed is the lack of a promoter for the project. The Scottish Government insists this is a developer-led project. Winchburgh Development have committed to partially funding the station. Then there is the possibility of funding from the City Region Deal. We need clarity on the funding and business cases for the station. I will be meeting with the Winchburgh developments later this month and hope to hear that further progress is being made. If we are to see station in the coming years, we must see collaboration between stakeholders, including MSPs. The Scottish Government should look at the enthusiasm evident today and the Winchburgh and steps up to deliver on the incredible opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chowdhury. And I now call on Lorna Slater. Ms. Slater.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and thank you to Sue Webber for securing this debate. Winchburgh was promised a train station. It needs a train station, and Winchburgh deserves a train station. This needs to be delivered. It is disappointing and frustrating to hear that there is still confusion and misunderstanding over who is to lead and fund the project. Constituents tell me that the developer has not been forthcoming and helpful with others, leading to delays, and that they have implied or made promises that they have not delivered on. Development of infrastructure to support communities must go hand in hand with building them. I understand that West Lothian Council, Transport Scotland, Network Rail, Winchburgh Developments are all to get together to meet again soon. They all need to get around the table to deliver this. Jobs and mobility depend on it. The Scottish Greens believe that a high-quality, well-connected public transport system plays a crucial role in delivering on our climate ambitions, reducing congestion, and helping to deliver a just transition to net zero. It boosts our economy by allowing people to get to work, to study, and keeping them connected with family and friends. After decades of underinvestment and austerity imposed by Labour and Tory governments in Westminster, investments in building a green economy and our public services is urgent. I would gently challenge Sue Webber on buses, as buses both reduce congestion and emissions by moving more people in a single vehicle. And also on the success of the trams in Edinburgh, which are not only popular and convenient for people like me who live in Leith, but in my experience have reduced congestion and improved air quality along Leith Walk. Transport emissions continue to increase, though, driven by a long-term and systematic failure to invest in public transport and infrastructure for walking, cycling, and wheeling. Building stations so that more communities can be served by our rail network will encourage more people onto public transport. Improving rail connections across Scotland should be a national priority, and therefore I strongly support the calls for the construction of a new station at Winchburgh. Further information and clarification of the responsibilities by the key agencies would provide assurance to the many constituents who have and continue to inquire about the possibility of this new rail station. The new station at Winchburgh would be a crucial component of the region's infrastructure, which would help reduce traffic congestion and play that significant role in reaching net zero, as well as providing accessible and affordable transport. I look forward to seeing the business case as it's developed and would welcome the announcement and date for the construction of the Winchburgh train station as soon as possible. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Slater. And I now call on Minister Jim Fairley to respond to the debate. Around 7 minutes, please, Minister.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. I'd like to thank all the members who have taken part in today's contribution. There's one point I'm going to make just before we move on. My friend Graham Simpson there made the point that building a station is not that difficult. I've got a load of officials who would tell me quite the opposite, I can assure you. The proposal for a new station at Winchburgh is traced back for two decades to the West Lothian Local Plan in 2004 and the Edinburgh and Lothian Structural Plan in 2005. And as soon as I get involved after my appointment as a minister, I made it as a priority to get a good understanding of what the issues were and, more importantly, how to progress the building of a station, which had been promised by the developers in their vision for a new community around the old village of Winchburgh. And I wanted to use the opportunity of this debate to set out what progress is being made. The idea to create the new station as part of the large-scale housing development was an ambitious and far-sighted plan, which I commend the developers and West Lothian Council for. Now, I've visited the area with the developer and the council, and I've seen firsthand the excellent work that they've done and can clearly see the vision taking shape. What was never clear to me, however, was how the narrative has developed that somehow the failing of a station being built over these past two decades was either Transport Scotland or Scottish ministers' fault or responsibility. It was absolutely clear, and I want to ensure that that fact is clearly understood, that this was and is a developer-led commitment, and any political posturing to say otherwise serves absolutely no one, least of all the people of Winchburgh, who members in this chamber are here to represent. Perhaps a wee bit of history behind this saga may help to put some context to the situation. The ambitious planning application for Winchburgh was submitted back by Winchburgh Developments in 2005. The application included provision for a new trunk road junction on the M9, a railway station and two park and ride facilities on the site. Currently, neither the railway station or the park and ride facilities have reached the point of delivery. A planning condition added to the consent by the planning authority allowed for a further assessment to demonstrate the need for a station at a later date. And this allowed the application for the site to be granted and discussions to accommodate the station later in the process. But it was still very clearly a developer-led ambition. Following discussions with Winchburgh Developments Limited, West Lothian Council, Transport Scotland and Network Rail, and further assessments in line with those discussions, it was agreed in February 2015 that the case for the rail station had been demonstrated, planning permission in principle for the station was granted in 2015, and it was expected that the application for detailed planning consent would follow in and around December 2017 by the developer. This did not happen. Throughout the period under which Winchburgh Rail Station has been under consideration, the policy of the Scottish Government has been clear that developers are required to provide any mitigation on infrastructure to support their development. At various points across that time, the developer has previously confirmed their intent to fund the station, and I've got documentation to confirm that fact. However, it's now become apparent that the developer no longer has the available funds to independently provide the required railway station at Winchburgh, and consequently, my officials are supporting the developer and the Council in seeking alternative sources of funding to support the delivery of the proposed station. The historic consideration and approvals in place for the station place no legal obligation on the developer or West Lothian Council to construct the Winchburgh station, which is unfortunate because the local authority had it within their power to put the obligation in place, so when granting the final permissions, but they failed to do so. This, added to the progressively worsening financial restrictions across all sectors, has contributed to a stagnation in respect of the progress of the station across the past several years. In the meantime, the developer has continued developing the community at Winchburgh and has successfully funded and delivered, with financial support from the Scottish Government, the new four-way junction on the M9, which opened in February 2023. However, it should be pointed out that this was a requirement of the developer's planning consent, which was supported, and I emphasise this, by my colleague and local constituency MSP Fiona Hislop, only as an addition to the requirement to build a railway station, not as a get-out or an alternative. Now, this was a legal requirement of the developer and should be seen as a requirement and as a direct result of the hard work and put in, let me try that again, of the hard work put in of bringing the people together by Fiona Hislop as the local constituency MSP, along with regional MSPs and their campaign to raise awareness of this matter. It's a matter of fact that the station proposal originated as a developer-led proposal, which added to the value of the overall saleability of the master plan, which I have to say I agree with, but it was never or ever has been the duty or requirement of Transport Scotland or the Scottish Government to be the lead promoter on the project. The only role Transport Scotland within the process was to act on behalf of the Scottish Government as a statutory consultee within the planning process led by the planning authority. Presiding Officer, overall, I think I can confidently say we have made significant progress in bringing a collegiate and productive group together who have all shared the goal of helping the local authority and Winchburgh Development Limited on the station that is clearly being demanded by local residents, businesses and, of course, the environment. All the interested parties I have met with are clear they have shared the objective on continuing that progress. To aid this, I believe it was vital to push support for the reformation of the Winchburgh Railway Station Steering Group, which Fiona Hislop had previously successfully done. And the group now comprises of the developer, West Coast Capital, West Lothian Council, Transport Scotland, Network Rail, City Region Deal and Sistran. And they are currently meeting on a four-weekly basis to progress the immediate next steps required for delivery of the station. One of the immediate requirements of the steering group is to investigate the potential sources to plug the gap required in lieu of the infrastructure elements the developer has either already delivered to support the station or has agreed by way of existing financial contributions. So work has also been undertaken to review and, where required, to update the business case to support the station proposal, and I understand that the developer and the council plan to meet soon to finalise who the lead promoter role is and identify appropriate project sponsor to lead with the delivery of the station. It would seem appropriate to me that the council and the developer may want to share that vital lead promoter role, but clearly that will be something that they will decide for themselves. My officials have reported to me that the productive nature of the first two meetings, and commend all parties for that positive and constructive nature which they have engaged, and I would urge them to continue in the spirit of cooperation and solution finding. I would also emphasise the need to allow that group the time and the space now to do the work that's needed and encourage others, particularly across this chamber, to remove the political opportunism that has become all too apparent to let that constructive nature of the developments know want. To be clear, Presiding Officer, the Scottish Government supports the provision of a station at Winchburgh, and officials at Transport Scotland will remain proactively involved with the proposal. Graeme Simpson.
Can I thank the Minister for taking the intervention? I want to congratulate him, actually, for facilitating the steering group meetings. And I think the message sounds quite positive. So can he just say whether he is now more confident than we have been for some time? Is he confident that this will actually happen? I'm not pinning him down to any dates or anything, but does he actually think that as a result of the work that he appears to have led, that we might actually see some progress?
Minister.
All I can say to the member is thank you very much. We absolutely support the provision of the station being built in Winchburgh. And as I've said, my Transport Scotland officials are going to be proactively involved in that proposal. The cross-stakeholder structure will only progress if all the parties involved continue to work in the constructive and collaborative nature that has been witnessed in recent months. So the message from here is to please continue. Please be positive and engage, and then please make sure that we get the station built for the people of Winchburgh. Thank you.
Thank you, Minister. That concludes the debate, and I close this meeting.